brass vessel in which that pongal is cooked has passed on from generations.
It's a vegetarian lunch.
Huh?
Yeah, with few dishes, simple, you know.
So lunch is sorted, and what about breakfast? So we're on the road, and we're heading to Shree's hometown, which is a place called Kuppam, right? In Chittoor district of Andhra Pradesh. There is a ceremony happening there, a puja, and that's the reason why we are headed there.
It's just our family god, Munishwara. So we do puja for him, you know, some kind of a small ceremony with our immediate family members, about 20-25 people. Yeah, when we made pongal, which is made of jaggery and ghee and everything, followed by lunch.
So you know what I'm most interested in. And so when Shree invited me, I said, okay, fine, let's taste that. Will I get to taste it, or that's only like for the gods?
No, no, you can taste.
Yeah? Okay, so hopefully I'll get to taste some of the chakre pongal. And they make it on that fire, right?
Yeah, wood fire.
They make that on that wood fire, in a pot.
It's a brass vessel. It's like a
brass vessel.
Yeah.
So is that vessel symbolic of something?
Yeah. It's been using from my great-grandmother to grandmother. And then
really?
It's like
so it's a
very old one.
So I'd seen it the last time around, even when I went. This was a couple of years ago or so. I didn't realize that the brass vessel in which that pongal is cooked as part of the ceremony has passed on from generations.
It's a vegetarian lunch.
Huh?
Yeah, with few dishes, simple, you know.
So lunch is sorted, and what about breakfast?
I am fasting because of the puja. So I'm not going to eat any breakfast, and straight away lunch, that's
coffee
I can have.
So probably before lunch we'll stop by for coffee somewhere. So stick around to this slice of life vlog. Hopefully you'll find it interesting. You know, the place that we are in currently, it's a place of foodies, this place in Tamil Nadu.
Yeah.
Sapadi. Sapadi is food.
Sapadi.
So when you say a foodie, so food with an E becomes foodie. So Sapadi is food in Tamil. So my logic is, therefore, Sapadi is the foodie equivalent in Tamil, right? Poor joke. She's not impressed at all. Boss's high standards of humor.
Nothing like that. I don't know exactly what does it mean, so...
Okay, mask on. I think the camera needs to be switched off now.
Driver
also eat. Okay, madam.
You
can eat it. One idli. Single podi idli, single vadai. Coffee. So we've stopped here at Murugan Idli in Krishnagiri, where I'm going to taste the podi idli. Actually, the plan was to just accompany Shree in the coffee because she's doing a fast, so she can't really have anything. But, you know, I saw the table next to us tucking into some podi idli there on that bale ele, on that banana leaf. And when you look at it, you want to have it. So we've got some podi idli happening, and also some vadai, a single vadai. I think that should keep me happy till the time that we reach Kuppam and do the pongal. So this is the pongal before lunch or after lunch?
After lunch.
Yeah. So therefore a light breakfast, just so that I'm able to preserve my appetite.
Well, it turns out it's Shree's first time here. And unfortunately, she's on a fast, so we'll have to return here to get Shree to taste that.
Pot of gold here at Murugan Idli. This is that podi idli, that ghee podi idli. What chutney is this? There's some curry leaf chutney there. Some pudina chutney, mint chutney. What is this? So there are all these chutneys that you can taste, but this podi idli, you can savour it just by itself. How's the coffee? Good?
In Tamil Nadu, coffee typically is very
good. See, all the coffee that goes into Tamil Nadu goes from Karnataka. So only the roasting is different, and I think in Tamil Nadu what they do is they like their coffee, I think, to have a little more body.
Yeah.
I think the roasts are deeper and probably the chicory is a little more. But we have to come here next time for you to taste the podi idli.
For sure.
For sure.
I like idli. Idli is my favorite breakfast.
So I'm feeling actually a bit guilty about just eating while Shree is just having coffee, nothing else. The vade, not the finest specimen today. The vade is flavorful but very stodgy. Boss, vade not good today. Light irka vade.
Soft
illa. Hard.
Tighter.
Tight irka vade. First time that I'm tasting actually a vade that's not great at Murugan. The flavor is fine because it's got all sort of things. It's got some onions, it's got some curry leaf, etc. But it's not light. This is a vade that is quite hard, quite gutty. So therefore, I've asked for another idli. That idli is a pot of gold here. That idli is what you need to come to Murugan Idli for. Whether in the plain form or in that podi form. Well, after all, when an establishment bases its name upon the idli, that idli better be good. You wouldn't forgive an establishment which has an idli on its name if they served you a bad idli. You know, the chutneys are so good. Whether it's the tomato chutney, the mint chutney, the curry leaf chutney and the coconut chutney. So we have an episode on Murugan Idli on Food Lovers TV. So I'm going to place a link to that video right here and also in the description below. That idli chutney combination here is a sort that makes you almost forget that sambar. And that would be a sad thing to do because the sambar here too is quite special. Sometimes I have people who come and ask me, who tell me, okay, you know, I went to this place and I didn't enjoy the food, it wasn't good, etc. But I think that's the thing with eateries, with establishments, with because it doesn't come out of a machine, because there's so much of human aspect that's involved, things can go wrong sometimes. So for instance, I've never had a bad vadai here, but today the vadai that I've served was unpardonable. And I think that's the nature of food. So I think by and large, most eateries like to do the best that they do, but because there is so much of the human aspect that determines the quality of the output, sometimes things can go wrong. And I think that's the nature of the food business. And a good establishment is one that is able to manage consistency over a longer period of time. So I think what's key is for an eatery to be consistent. See you.
Thank you.
Happy riding. Yeah. Safe riding. See you.
Bye.
See you guys.
Brass, this utensil.
Okay.
This is a traditional one. This is done by those who are having this Kotamuneshwar Swami puja. They will prepare and they will do it with the full of. Upavasa and all, they will say upavasa, full fasting, and from morning they will not take anything except coffee or something, milk or like. And after performing puja to Kotamuneshwar Swami and Surya Pongal, Surya Narayana Swami, this is prepared with pure milk, jaggery, and ghee. That's all.
There,
no more ingredients are added into that.
Lot of neem.
Yeah, ghee is lot of there.
So the puja is over now downstairs, and we saw all of that. And now I'm looking forward to tasting that pongal. But I think the tradition is that the ladies will eat first.
We will give them turmeric, kumkuma, and all that. We will give them sweets, fruits, and sari and all. We will give them and we will ask them to bless.
Ask them to bless.
Bless. Yes. They will bless us. That is our family tradition.
And then puliyogare,
okay.
And then kosumbri, pineapple gujju, and some potato peas palya, and beans palya, and some sandige, and
mirchi bhaji.
Mirchi bhaji.
Fantastic.
Yeah, that's it. Let me eat peacefully.
So the customers are the ladies eat first. And they're the ones who bless the rest of the family. And in due course, we'll also get to our Balayale. So it's nice to take a look at all the customs and traditions that families have been practicing over generations, actually. So the ladies have eaten, now the men will eat.
They will not have the breakfast.
So the ladies are fasting for the men folk. So therefore, the least the men folk can do is feed them.
Yeah, so make sure they do the lunch first.
Nothing like a banana leaf to get the appetite going. Begin with a sweet, no? First? Mmm, a lot of tuppa.
Only tuppa.
The jaggery is there, but you can taste more of the tuppa. Mmm, delicious. Moist crunch of the kosambri. No raw mango in this?
Mango lemon rice.
Mmm.
Mango is added flavor. Mango is from Tirumanamalai.
Mango is from Tirumanamalai. Okay. I think they give me an extra serving of the ghee. Because I'm sitting next to the son-in-law of the house.
Oh, okay.
So I got some extra ghee, I think. Because I'm sitting next to Nikhil here.
Sambar.
Sambar.
Kootu.
Oh, okay. Kootu. The kootu is very nice.
Taste is with rasam.
Yeah. Some bison too. Fair bit is happening on this bale ale. This banana leaf. I've got the pongal, I've got some rice, I've got some kootu, some chitranna with some mango, some beans, palya, bhaji, potato, kosambri. The sweet pongal that I tasted first, and now also some paisam. Half of that. What's coming next?
Did you eat sambar and rasam?
I ate the kootu.
Oh, then it's rasam.
Rasam, okay. Well, the exciting thing about banana leaf is there's always something coming. There's something coming up. All that you need to do is keep your appetite on the ready. Mm. The same pongal we ate, right?
Yes.
How about that?
After rasam.
Yeah, okay. So after all that pepper, you need to have some sweet.
Before any curry.
So you won't say no to a pongal that's been slow cooked over a wood fire. So this time they put some coconut also on that, on the pongal.
They'll put some ghee also.
Fantastic.
Acha.
You can never say no to ghee. Mo nahi. That's a good combination with the rasam.
Lemon rice, right? Yeah.
See, that pepper gets stronger in that. So you've got that combination of the lemon and the pepper. That's a poppy seed paisam.
Yes.
That's it. So that's Nikhil, my lunch partner. Shree's niece's husband.
Yeah.
Gasgase paisam is delicious. And now, some more of that pongal with the freshly grated coconut and oodles of nei, ghee. If I have the curd rice after this, then that curd rice will take away this flavor.
That will take away, yeah.
I want the flavor of the pongal and that nei.
Some more time.
Till I have a cup of coffee or something like that later.
Yeah.
I don't want to let go of the flavor of that pongal. And the crunch of the coconut is also drawing from the sweetness of the jaggery in the pongal. In the pongal, delicious. Happiness on a banana leaf here in Kuppam. Chitranna. That also had some mango in it.
Yeah.
Even that gasgase paisa. Did you try it?
No, I didn't try. I had only
pongal. I think the best was the pongal.
It was prepared by my aunt.
Yeah, it was really nice. And especially with the kai.
Coconut
with the coconut and the ghee. Super. So we just finished at Shree's place. Delicious lunch. Also nice to catch the puja and try and understand what was happening. The ladies were given the...
Yeah, some gifts, whatever.
Ladies are given gifts. Well, the men were no gifts.
You got something, no? Some cup or something. Yeah,
the ladies got saris, I got a mug. On a serious note, I think it was good to see what was happening and have a different day as opposed to what we typically do. I think for me, the best part of the day was just watching things unfold. Of course, we reached late, otherwise we could have... Yeah. I wanted to see the...
Starting.
The pongal being made.
Yeah.
Not the starting of the puja, I think that... No. Starting ending is more or less the same for me personally. I mean, I'm sure there is a meaning to the ceremony, the rituals, etc. But I was most interested in watching that pongal being cooked. The pongal was almost done by the time we got there.
Did you have the bhaji that...
The bhaji. That bhaji was also nice. So who was the guy who prepared the food?
His name is Kittanna. So he always does for all our functions, you know, like in our hometown. So he makes excellent chutney podis and then idli podi and then the sambar powder. He's got a lot of clientele, you know, from the US.
Really?
From Kuppam, whoever had gone to the US, right? So, you know,
they take Kittanna's podi.
Kittanna's podi. And he's very good. All his powders, you know.
He's very hands-on. He's the one doing the service and everything.
Yeah, everything. He does everything.
So that's why I couldn't really speak to him much. But I think that's the nice thing about, you know, these Balayale Utas, and especially when it's not a very big sort of a elaborate function, because there, the cook who prepares the food along with his helpers, etc., is serving you himself. So I wish I could have spoken to him, but the, you know, the flip side is that because he's the one who's cooked and then brings all the things and then serves you, he's quite busy making sure that everybody is, you know, enjoying their banana leaf meal. Balayale Uta is always most satisfying,
yeah.
Right? I mean, it doesn't, whether you're in a restaurant or you're eating, you know, a nice meal at a puja in a home.
Velpainam, highway kelpainam. Concern, no?
Yeah. So I think that's a wonderful thing about small towns. I think the sense of involvement of everyone, right?
Yeah.
Whether it's the cook who's cooking that meal for you or the family who's involved in multiple roles. And of course, the other aspect of a Balayale Uta is also when you, in a small family, do like this. I think it also is a great way of meeting people. You know, everybody sitting together on the table, the family is serving. There's a different kind of interaction, right?
Yeah.
No? So the puja, of course, everybody is busy. Everybody has their roles. And I think there are people in charge of various aspects. Somebody's in charge of cooking the pongal, somebody's in charge of the coconuts, somebody's in charge of the camphor, and somebody's in charge of the, what do you call them, the bhajans. But I think when it comes to food, then everybody starts really, you know, chilling out, so to speak, after the puja is done. And I think a banana leaf meal, because it's a family that's serving the family, so it's a nice way of also socializing, meeting. So it was fun.
Yeah.
It was a good, great afternoon, actually.
Yeah,
I
liked it.
I enjoyed it. And, you know, also I was taking some footage here and there. So because I was taking the footage, I also wanted to understand a little more. And I think that's what the camera also does sometimes for me. Because, you know, otherwise you're just observing. But because you are also recording it, and you're also recording it to share, right? So you also want to know the meaning of what's happening a little more. So I think that is, to me, a good thing when I'm, you know, holding a camera. I want to know more so that if I know more, then you also understand a little more of what's happening out there. Now, what do you call a Balayale Uta in Telugu?
Aretaku. Banana leaf is aretaku.
But it's, I've never heard anybody say it.
It's a very common thing, you know, like nobody says anything, you know, like...
This is bhojanam, basically.
Bhojanam, they say. That's it. Bhojanam means, by default, it will be you're eating on a nice... green leaf. So yeah,
so yes, so she's basically telling, what are you getting so excited about? Eating off a leaf. This is how people typically eat. So I think that's our slice of life vlog for today. I don't know what the edit will look like, but you're obviously seeing this at the end of the vlog, so which means you've probably found it interesting enough to stay on till this point. If you did enjoy this watch, give this video a thumbs up. And do consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. We are now between Kuppam and Krishnagiri. Stop at Krishnagiri for a cup of coffee.
Yeah.
And some gas. And we'll be on our way to Bengaluru. Until the next one, take care, stay safe. Bye-bye.